हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ आरसीए एजुकेशन हब बानसूर एंड आवर चैप्टर नंबर 8 इज गोइंग ऑन मिनरल न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स। ओके, सो हियर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द मिनरल न्यूट्रिएंट्स। ओके, एंड फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द एसेंशियल मिनरल न्यूट्रिएंट्स। अप टू नाउ अप्रोक्सीमेटली 117 एलिमेंट्स आर नोन इन नेचर and out of that about 60 elements are present in plants। okay, 60 elements are found or present in plants। out of that, according to the studies, it was found that not 60 elements but 17 essential elements are there which are essential for the healthy growth of the plants। ओके, सो आउट ऑफ 60, 17 एलिमेंट्स आर मस्ट फॉर द हेल्दी ग्रोथ ऑफ द प्लांट्स। दीज एसेंशियल मिनरल न्यूट्रिएंट्स आर लेटर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर कंसंट्रेशन रिक्वायर्ड बाय द प्लांट, दे आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स। वन आर मैक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड अनदर आर माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स। सो मैक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स आर दोज न्यूट्रिएंट्स और दोज मिनरल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट अबाउट 1 to 10 milligram per dry weight of the plants। okay, it means their concentration is much, it means at least 1 to 10 milligram of minerals are present at per dry weight of plants। okay, whereas micronutrients, these are present in less than 1 milligram per dry weight of the plants। so macronutrients, as name suggests, that these are required in large amount। so these are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, potassium, okay, magnesium, calcium, understand? so carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, potassium, sulfur and phosphorus also there, is that clear? sulfur and phosphorus, so these are the macronutrients: carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, potassium, magnesium, calcium, sulfur and phosphorus। these are the macronutrients which are present in the large amount in the plants। another are micronutrients which are present in less amount in the plants। so these are iron, boron, zinc। okay, iron, boron, zinc, manganese, copper, molybdenum, okay, nickel, understand? so these are the micronutrients, which are those iron, boron, zinc, manganese, molybdenum, chlorine also there and nickel, is that clear? and chlorine, so these are the micronutrients। some other elements are also there which are known as intermediate elements। okay, so intermediate elements are iron and boron, as because in some plants they are present in greater amount whereas in some plants they are present in less amount, so these are known as intermediate elements, is that clear? all these nutrients are very essential, very important for the healthy growth of the plants। okay students, so let's continue the topic beta। before that we discuss that how essential mineral nutrients, which are 17, they are divided into the two parts, macronutrients and micronutrients, on the basis of their amount, how much amount required by the plants। so here macronutrients are those minerals which are required in 1 to 10 milligram per dry weight of the plants। later on macronutrients again divided into the two parts, primary macronutrients and secondary macronutrients। primary macronutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium and NPK, these are the three main and important macronutrients which are known as primary macronutrients। if we discuss about the secondary macronutrients, so these are magnesium and sulfur. These are named as secondary macronutrients. Okay, except these 17 essential mineral nutrients, some other elements are also there which are known as beneficial nutrients. Okay, beneficial nutrients. Which are those? Those are sodium, scandium, silicon. Is that clear? Sodium, scandium, silicon. These are known as the beneficial nutrients. Okay, except this one, cobalt is also there. So these are known as the beneficial nutrients. Okay, now let me discuss about the known mineral nutrients. Known mineral nutrients. So known mineral nutrients are especially three main nutrients. Okay, which put under the class of macronutrients, and these are carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, these known mineral nutrients are macronutrients, and these form about 90 to 95% of the plant part. Okay, these are required in large amount, and these known mineral nutrients are absorbed by the plants from the atmosphere. Okay, from the atmosphere, from the water, as well as from the soil. So these are the three main sources of these known mineral nutrients, which are carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. These play important role in the protoplasm and wall formation of the cells of the plant. And one more thing is that in deficiency of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, if they are lacking in the plants, or deficiency of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen causes, or they affect the metabolism of fat, protein and carbohydrate. Okay. So during the when carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are deficient in the plants, so in one or another way, the metabolic activities of the fat, protein or carbohydrate or their synthesis should be affected. Okay.